The world fell. Humanity adapted. We learned to depend on ourselves for survival. But people still need driving apps, no matter what.
I gotta ask you a question. You know, sometimes when I get one of these drive shares, I'm looking at the app and I see the car, it's like parked, or it's just like driving in circles or something.
Very common complaint. Usually that's because I'm being chased.
Oh, of course, of course. Look at me, now I'm an idiot. I forgot about that.
Someone's trying to like cut off my legs and have sex with them, so I'm fleeing for my life. So I'm sorry if I'm just a little bit late picking you up.
All right. I mean, I'm not saying you, I'm just saying the general drive share people. Some chrome?
No, thank you.
It's a disgusting habit, I know, but you know, I did this when I was a kid. So I'm kind of like, I don't want to say addicted because that's a strong word.
Sure.
Kind of enjoy it. You know, and then I've tried the gold stuff. I don't like the gold stuff. The silver really is special. And I mean, let's face it. I say it doesn't look cool, but it does look
cool. It looks cool. It looks very cool.
Ah. Do you have any water?
That's a good one. That's a good one. What I wouldn't do for just one sip. Just one sip!
Hey, are you going to the water drop this week?
No, there's a water drop this week.
Oh, you gotta go.
Oh.
It's so much fun. It's the first and third Sunday of every month.
Do we know that that's water for a fact? That's real water?
It's definitely
there's
water.
There's no chance that that's like...
Well, you heard the piss thing, right?
Yeah, it's not pee, right? There's no way it's pee.
No, that's a...
I'm not gonna drink a human pee.
Myth. It's an ermine myth.
You know what I'm really sick of?
What?
This humongous guy. Why don't we get rid of him? No one ever talks about that.
You asked me 6 months ago, will humongous still be in power? I was like, no way.
No way.
But, you know,
he's crazy. He says crazy, racist stuff all the time.
He's doing something right, though. You know, he just figured out that you could milk women, and that would cause sort of a baby explosion. You know, people got excited about that.
Why didn't I think of that? Of course you can milk women. Of course you can.
We should explain, if you've seen that clip, that was the whole series does not take place in a Mad Max world.
No, that was a one-off. That was our last one. We shot a million funny, normal Uber rides.
120 Uber rides.
And then
Uber
the last
rides.
One, we were like, what's a one we haven't done? Oh, well, like a Mad Max one.
Like, what would Uber be in the world of Mad Max?
In the
but
future.
If you see that first, you might
it's
be
confusing.
Like,
it's confusing.
What the fuck? Why?
The show is mainly fucked up Uber ride. Like, the worst thing that could happen, you know, like a woman giving birth in the back seat.
A driver who tries to make you have sex with a Uber pool passenger.
Yeah, yeah. All kinds of crazy
classic
stuff.
Classic stuff. Dilemmas.
Yeah. But how are you guys?
Yeah.
Good.
Thank you. Thank you for coming all the way out here. This is very exciting.
I like that we told everyone to look under their seats as if there was going to be something, and then everyone's just bummed out. It was like, there's nothing under my seat.
We don't look under our seats enough, though. Isn't
we
that
don't.
A metaphor?
As a metaphor.
We don't take, we're
as
on
a metaphor,
our phones.
We gotta
we're never
do
looking
that
under
more.
Our seats. Maybe there is something special there. I went to a show last night. There was a baby under my seat.
Is that true?
A live baby. I left it there.
Was it my baby?
I could have been.
Paul and I just had babies. Congratulations.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
And you can leave the gifts by the door.
We should clarify that we did not make each other's babies. I did not get Paul pregnant, was
no,
what I'm trying to say.
Rob got my wife pregnant, and I got Rob's wife pregnant.
Thank you
and
for
that's,
clarifying
and that's like
that.
Teamwork right there, 100%.
Yes. Your wife is really great at sex.
Thank you, Rob, as is yours.
Thank you.
Now Paul, the baby you found under your seat wasn't his baby, was it?
I don't think it was. No, I don't think
our baby's missing. I will have to check.
I put a playbill in that baby's mouth because he cried during the most of the show. I don't know. Oh, I think I left it there, too. It's tough.
We did have, for real, we just had babies. And we're both... Does anyone here have a baby? No?
This is New York City.
But you guys know
you
where babies come from.
You don't have babies here.
You're not allowed to... Donald Trump won't let you have
safe
babies, right?
Safe sex. Safe sex. Keep
we
it protected.
We live in California where you're still allowed to have babies. And so we did that, and now we're both very sleep deprived. We don't sleep.
And I thought, oh, it would be great. We'll come to New York and get to sleep in. But no, because 9 o'clock is like 6 a.m. here. We're screwed again.
Yeah. I want to tell my wife, is this camera us? I want to tell my wife, I'm not having any fun in New York. I'm not enjoying sleeping in a hotel room where it's quiet and ordering room service all the time.
Yes.
I don't like that.
Tell my wife right now.
I want to be home with you.
I don't want to be eating at fancy restaurants and seeing cool shows. I want to
Hamilton.
Be home watching Thomas the Train.
Yes.
Thomas the Train.
Paw Patrol.
That's a show.
Paw Patrol is a good show.
Paw Patrol is one of those shows like Game of Thrones. You gotta watch it with the Wikipedia page out.
Gotta watch it a couple times.
Gotta find out why.
Yeah.
Well, we're very excited to be here. Rob, you are nominated for La La Land, right?
I am. Yeah, this is Academy Award weekend. I'm very nervous. I did learn to play the piano for my part.
He's so good at it.
Thank you very much. We haven't involved you at all.
I won an email contest to sit up on stage with you guys, so...
Rob! Sorry. You're wrecking the set!
I spilled water. Are we in danger? There's a lot of electrical shit around here.
You just... Oh, my God.
Sorry. Always put this at hand level where people can easily swipe it like that. It's a great idea.
Do you want a refill? I've only sipped out of it twice.
No, this was vodka. It's fine. But for real, how are you?
I'm great. Thank you for asking.
Who do you think is going to win at the Oscars?
I think it's going to be a tie across the board.
Across the board, no winners. Tie. Yep.
Yes.
Could be.
I was upset that John Wick 2 wasn't nominated for anything.
Why isn't John Wick 2 nominated?
It didn't come out in time. I don't think that's a good point.
If they had category for the most amount of bullets to the head, I feel like it would win. It's in the category
I get the feeling that a lot of you have not seen John Wick 2.
Why not?
Did you see John Wick 1? It's
why not?
Great movie.
Go see John Wick 1. And then go see John Wick 2. That's how it goes. Or go see John Wick 2 and then treat the first one like a prequel.
You're not going to not like it.
Yeah.
Unless you're a woman. I feel like a woman might not.
Wait a second, Rob.
That's very sexist.
Wait a second.
What I said was very sexist.
Kellyanne Conway over here. No, I think that John Wick transcends gender.
Okay, great. I agree. I'm sorry, ladies. You'll love it. If you like seeing...
Dig yourself out of this hole by yourself now.
Yeah, we're going to let that hang.
If you like seeing dudes get blown away in the face.
Well, John Wick 2 has a very strong female character who's a mute. It is true.
Baby steps, is that what you're saying?
Baby steps in, yeah.
That's crazy.
All right.
He's a badass.
Guys, let's talk about Drive Share. Can we do
show?
That? Yeah. Can we talk about this thing
let's
that's on this board
so
over here?
Everyone here has been in an Uber ride, right? Everyone's been in a shitty Uber ride. I'm sure everyone can relate to that. So we got all of our funny friends in L.A. to come out and shoot the show with us. It's all like Jack McBrayer and...
Adam Pally,
Jason Mantzoukas, and Scott Aukerman,
Milo Sinopoulos,
Jessica St. Clair, right?
all of
Jessica
our super
St. Clair in the mix.
Jessica St. Clair, yeah. So all of our comedy buddies came out and we shot a million of it's a sketch comedy show in an Uber.
It airs every single day for 30 days. We're in the middle of it right now.
The beauty of it is you don't have to fucking sign up for shit. You don't have
to
subscribe.
It's not a hidden subscription fee.
Go and watch it on go90.
Yeah, it's totally free. It's basically a sketch show that takes place only in an Uber. Like that's really what it is. And every day is like about 2 to 3 rides.
And if you don't like Uber, it's not really Uber.
It's Lyft.
We support Lyft.
This came
Fuck
out
Uber.
The morning after Delete Uber. Literally the
it's
morning
true.
After.
We're That's like, true.
What? Come on now. How can we promote an Uber show after everyone deleted it?
That's true.
But didn't
That's
care because everyone who deleted it probably put it right back on their phone like a week later. Like, oh, I'm deleting it. And then they're like, all right, well, I'll just let
That's true. Have you guys used Uber since then?
I have not. Lyft is better.
I use it one time, but I told him the whole time I was pissed off. I was like, just so you know, I don't like this company.
I only use pedicabs. If you're not familiar, that's where the guy bikes with you on the back. It's
politically
fair.
Correct. Yeah. Politically correct. Yeah, I agree. That's a good call.
Very cool. Well, you guys have been working together for infinity. It seems. So if we could turn on the Wayback Machine for a second.
Yeah. God, UCB. I'm so thirsty.
Bob, you're going to be solely.
Again, second offer. You only have one more of
no,
that.
No, thank you.
Okay.
Mine was vodka.
You guys met at the UCB Theater here in New York City?
Here in New York, yeah.
Before the UCB Theater was actually a theater, it was on the fifth floor of like an abandoned building.
A strip club. You remember we took over? Yeah. It was actually the very first real one was in a strip club. On 22nd Street?
And we were responsible for like painting and making that theater nice. And here's the thing. Don't try to refurbish a strip club. It's disgusting.
It's disgusting. Don't ever rent an old strip club and think you can make it into a nice place because it's really gross.
And let me tell you.
And really gross people come by all the time.
The clientele was not aware that it wasn't a strip club.
No. Yeah,
they thought. Show, people be like,
for so many years, people would come to UCB.
Walk right
And they thought like, oh, this is, where are the tits? Oh, they're not here? Okay. What are these, jokes? I don't like jokes.
I do think that there is something funny to someone coming to a strip club and then watching the first 5 minutes of a sketch show or a Harold and being like, oh, interesting, I like the theme here.
Not what I came here for, like, but I do like this.
And only very short music at the very beginning, right?
Yeah.
Bring the music back.
So yeah, we came up through UCB, and then we used to do a show a long time ago called Human Giant that we shot here in New York, a sketch show for MTV. That was a long time ago.
Yeah.
With our buddy Aziz. And then we both just took a nosedive into heroin and cocaine for about 12 years.
We had some pretty bad investments.
People don't know
time.
That we're kidding. People are like, oh, that's sad.
So is that before or after Blackballed? Is that?
Oh my gosh!
Wow, that's a deep cut. That's a deep cut. That was an early film.
Movie, that called Blackballed. It was a mockumentary about paintball. Before everyone made a mockumentary about.
It was the. I would say it's the first mockumentary about paintball.
Screw you, Christopher Guest. First mockumentary. It was predated Spinal Tap. It just came out way later. And but it's, I would say first and only.
We've had a lot of weird jobs now that you think about it, because we also had jobs briefly. You probably don't remember this. We had a job writing on the John McEnroe show.
Yeah.
John McEnroe had a talk show. When we lived in New York, had a talk show in New York for about a month.
They
hired us to come in and like write comedy for John McEnroe, who was a nice guy.
Lovely
guy. No offense to John McEnroe,
but
not known for comedy.
Not known.
Wouldn't
that
you
a talk
agree?
Show host.
Right.
Like, they literally were going to do a Pardon the Interruption where he was going to be the sports guy, but then they couldn't find anyone else to co-host with them, so then it just became like a straight-up talk show with John McEnroe
doing like an opening monologue, like coming out and doing jokes. John McEnroe does not like to do jokes.
Well, doing jokes for an audience that was mostly not from this country, because they would just basically get tourists who were coming to New York City for the first time and going like, hey, you guys want pizza? Pizza? And be like, yeah. And they put them on a bus.
To New Jersey. It was in New Jersey.
And they're like, what? They're like, here's the pizza. Now you have to watch a two-hour-long TV tape.
And me and Paul would come out as like, we would write dumb comedy bits. We would come out as like a robot or whatever to do a bit with John McEnroe. And McEnroe... you know, would be John McEnroe. He'd be like, you're not a robot. You're Paul Scheer.
You're one of the writers on our show.
It's like, come on, McEnroe. Like, go along with the bit. So that was an early job we had.
We had a lot of weird,
terrible comedy jobs.
Well, flash forward to you guys being on a bus yet again. You guys.
That's right. We did a comedy special.
Comedy
last
special
year.
On a bus.
Rob, more water for
oh,
you.
Oh, there it is.
Thank you for the water.
Hilarious.
Oh, that's good vodka. we did a comedy special last year.
On a moving bus. We're basically only doing
vehicular comedy.
Yeah, that's it.
We only do comedy on a vehicle. What's a good vehicle we haven't done?
Plane and duck boat. That's what I'm talking about. Duck boat.
Blimp.
Get
helicopter.
What about a glider? Like one of those hanging gliders?
Great idea.
Our death will be our comedy special
on a
blimp.
On a blimp.
We will recreate the Hindenburg.
The Hindenburg,
What a great comedy show until they all burn to a crisp.
Yeah. But yeah, so we did a crash test, which was on a bus. So maybe a roller coaster would also be a good place.
Just see a lot of ups and downs.
Yeah.
I could see the tagline for the blimp death. Oh, the hilarity, right? Is on the poster.
Oh, the hilarity.
All right, well, that brings us to drive share, because we've all used these car sharing apps, right? We've all had the experience.
It's relatable. It's fun.
Yes.
I've had weird experiences. I feel like I'm also the guy that the Uber driver assumes that we're going to be friends. Do you get that? Like at the end of the ride, he's always like, so, you know, obviously I know where you live, so.
Right.
I want an option where you can just select no talking. When you get the car, it's like, we won't talk. Like, I think that would be a nice option.
Or just a little sign that everyone should hold up. Just be like, no. No.
I've had deaf Uber drivers who have handed back a card to me saying, I'm deaf.
That's not true.
I'm being totally serious. I've had that happen. Does anyone ever?
More than once you've had a deaf Uber driver.
15 times.
Say, here's a card that says I'm deaf.
I do have facial blindness, so I may have been the same guy 15 times.
Okay. Is that a thing? Is facial blindness?
Yeah, one of my doctors has facial blindness. And he told me this.
What is facial blindness?
Dude, this is crazy. You can't, like, you don't recognize faces. So when his wife comes up to him, he doesn't recognize.
That's terrifying.
And so he sold, like, one of his other patients was a writer for Rizzoli and Isles. And they took his premise. He was a guy who saw a murder, but he couldn't tell them who the murderer was.
We mainly came on this show to promote Rizzoli and Isles. That's
if you haven't seen it, it's kind of like a cooler burn notice.
I love
or
that.
Suits. I should have said
the other
suits.
Thing. I feel like those back to the driver guys. I feel like they are always having the same conversations with people.
That's where I was going to go with that. I feel like I have the same conversation with them.
Yeah, because they get into a car.
But it's worse for them. It's worse for them because we are always asking them the same questions. Like, hey, did you just start working?
How long you been driving for Uber?
Like, right. Who cares? Like, why do you care about my life? It's not like I keep up. Yeah.
It should be more like. On our end, where you just make random conversation, yeah. Like, hey, man, do you want to see a dead body?
Or like, hey, is this a rash or a cyst? Take a look, you know, like.
On you?
Yeah, on me.
What do you think this is, a rash?
Just lift up my shirt. And I'll do full VFX makeup. I mean, I'm always able to do that.
I also feel like you should be able to take food into an Uber and offer it to the guy. You know, like, hey, I just
made
this.
Not homeless.
Good point. Some of them might be. We don't know.
Well, I mean, they probably, like, if they live in their car, then you're basically coming over for dinner. So then it would be appropriate to bring some food over.
Yes.
I had a deaf Uber driver. You ever tell you about that?
Yeah, you told me about that. You also said that you have facial blindness.
Oh, yeah.
The first of its kind.
So listen, Aziz, now I was.
You really do have facial blindness.
Well, should we start involving the audience?
Yeah,
yes. Everybody, look under
I
your
feel
seats.
Like,
look yeah. under your seats. Take a moment to look under your seats.
There's microphones under everybody's seat, right?
Oh my God!
But yeah, let's find out if they've gone on some strange rides. Because
well, yeah, or anything. Just ask us anything. If you have problems in your life, you want us to help you write a text.
Oh,
message.
We're really gonna open it up. Okay,
yeah, let's open it up.
If anyone has a
I think
rash,
you got the premise of Drive Share. I don't think we have to crack it open anymore. It's not like you know, we're talking about our inspiration for writing Moonlight. You know, it's like it's pretty base. It's a sketch comedy show that takes place in Uber. Got it. Let's move on. It's on Go90. Let's open up the field.
Yes. Hey guys, been fans of yours since The Human Giant.
Thank you. First of all, your name and
a secret about yourself.
A secret.
Yeah. Secret?
What's your name and what's the secret?
My name is Muffson and I am secretly a bathroom singer.
Oh.
A what?
Bathroom singer?
A bathroom singer.
Yeah. I like to hum sometimes.
By the way, I like how that came out. Okay.
Is that the same as like a shower singer?
It's kind of.
But you're
sometimes
on the
when
toilet?
You're taking a poop.
Yeah, it's like no one around.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Blurred lines.
Yeah. Get out of there. I got to use the bathroom.
Bad and bougie on the toilet. All right.
Okay, so we got that.
With this show, did you guys had any crazy Uber stories?
Great question. Rob, I'm going to let you
In
take
real
it.
Life, I had a story that this a real guy. I got into a car a while ago, and it was an older guy. And I thought, oh, that's interesting. This is a 70s-ish guy. And
was he deaf?
He was not deaf.
Okay.
And he did not have facial blindness. But he started telling me about how he got carjacked. And because I told him, I was like, oh, we're doing a funny comedy show about funny Uber rides. Has anything funny ever happened to you? And he was like, one time I got carjacked. I was like, that is not a funny story. So it was weird to me that he thought that was really funny.
I had a driver who had a full DJ setup in the passenger seat of the front of the car. And he was like, we're going to rock home.
Oh, God.
What music do you like? And we're like, I don't know.
How about my band?
And he just started literally scratching in the car.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah.
That's
By the way,
good.
It was a great ride. I didn't tip him.
It was a two-hour ride.
No, yeah.
All right, question over here.
So your name and a terrible secret about yourself.
Terrible secret.
My name is Jawad. And,
nice. Welcome.
Thanks. Terrible secret. Terrible secret is... Or just a
it
secret.
It is a secret. A secret.
No one's going to know.
I hit a kid once in my car.
He hit a kid once with his car? Wait, how?
Not today.
Security.
You hit a
Security.
Kid. All right.
Wait, what year? What year?
Right, from now on, the game will not be terrible secrets about yourselves.
First of all,
no one else can. Now we're all.
Is the kid okay? Is the kid okay?
I think so, yeah.
Oh!
Buddy, we're all involved now.
We are all.
We have to arrest you.
We have to protect him with everything.
Oh,
all right,
my God.
Yes, your question.
No one else confessed to crimes.
Don't ask, do we ever do one where we hit a kid? We did. We did do one where we hit a kid.
We actually did do a funny Uber ride where...
Kids don't get hit, an adult.
Okay, so yeah. What's your question? And then we got several questions for you.
Are there any guest stars or people that you want
to
bring
like
on the show?
These seem like planted questions.
These are questions that I would ask myself about the show.
Are there any guest stars? Great question.
Tons. Did we already say?
Adam Pally, Jack McBrayer,
Jason Manzoukas, Jessica St. Clair, Scott Aukerman,
Paul F. Tompkins,
Alex Berg,
Aquafina.
Literally hundreds. Like, who do you like in comedy? Yes, they're on the show.
Yeah, we have like basically 103 different chances.
Are there
unless you like
you
Rob Schneider. Rob Schneider's not on the show.
Let's get a question not related to Drive Share for a second.
Wait, let's get let's drill down. Okay, we're going to let it go.
We'll go back to that. Right. Yeah, we'll wrap up with that.
Yeah, welcome, sir.
Hi.
Hi.
Stand up. What's your name? How about just a secret, not a crime?
Great. Yeah. My secret is my son was hit by a car.
My name's Robert, and I don't have a belly button because of surgery when I was a baby.
Wow.
Great.
Nice.
That's the kind
of
secret.
Can we see it? I would like, can we see it?
You can.
All right.
Whoa!
That's awesome.
You guys, if you've never seen a person without a belly button, you are missing out.
It paid off. That paid off huge.
You must get laid all the time.
Yeah, I love that.
By anyone. Just be like, hey, do you want to have sex with me?
Yeah. Bam. All right, I love
it. I'm a huge fan of Transparent, and
I was wondering
if you could talk a little bit about that experience.
Yeah, I would love to.
Okay, well, I'll talk a little bit about
Paul's not on the show.
Involved and transparent to me. Yeah, go.
Paul's not on the show, guys. We're shooting season.
Should be on it. How many seasons has it been?
We're shooting season four right now. I shot with them yesterday. If you don't know, the show is on Amazon. It's won a lot of awards. Yeah, it's super fun. Jeffrey Tambor is the coolest person in the world, and the fact that for me to watch. Someone that, you know, I just loved him. Like, I was such a fan of his, like, for so long. So to see him now, like, at this point in his career, get to play such a cool part that's, like, really resonating culturally, especially right now, is awesome. It's really fun to watch that happen to him and for him. But also, it's just cool to be on a show like that that is really connected with people and is so... It's an important show.
I know how Rob feels because I did a show called
important.
The League.
Transparent, important.
I did a show called The League where there was a whole episode
about important.
People playing cock chicken. And that was an important episode. Would they touch each other's penises? I felt like we had a responsibility to the audience to
very
portray that
stuff.
With
It was a gateway episode, correct. You know? Transparent gets made,
yeah.
So very important. All right, great question and great
another
secret.
Another
nice
secret.
Yeah.
Great secret.
With this guy, yeah.
Oh,
still, we have to address the fact at some point.
Oh, it's in the back.
Someone hit someone with a car. We are not addressing the elephant in the room.
Notice he's sitting all the way in the back now. He actually was up front. Before,
there's now so cops he's talking to the guy who said he hit someone with his car.
We have to stay in here until the cops come. Everyone
yes, sir. What's
cool.
your name and what's the secret?
Well, the name part, what do you think is the first letter in my name?
R.
T.
No. It's
no. We could do this all day long, buddy.
Give us 20 more guesses. M.
B.
No.
C.
No. Close.
T.
No. Just go up
B.
a little. No.
By the way,
from C, go up.
Whoever was watching the show just
e?
Clicked off. They're like, I'm not into this.
G.
I'm not into it. I liked it before, but once the guy came on making them
guess
just
letters.
Guess letters.
Okay,
what's your name?
You actually think that we really want to know your name.
Being coy with the name. I want to do this when I meet people. Guess it. Guess the first letter. It is a good conversation starter.
What is
you
your name?
You just gamed us. We were into you.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. I'm glad to be, you know, someone's finally into me.
Yeah,
you know?
Of course.
My name is Avon.
Welcome.
Avon.
Avon.
I was going to guess that.
Up from C.
He said close. He said close.
I should have gone. I thought up was like... D-E-F.
Okay, Avon, what's your secret?
Tisk, tisk. My question was, what is you guys' morning routine? You seem so full of energy. Like, do you guys anything, like, abnormal?
Cocaine, yes. A ton
Well, but
of
I will first
cocaine.
Point out, it's not morning right now. It is about 5 o'clock.
You know it's like 5.
You're
it's
right.
like 5 in the afternoon.
You're
so
right.
This is
so
about
our morning
right
routine has nothing to do with this.
It's okay, not 5 a.m.
How is you guys... afternoon, yeah. your routine.
Yeah.
What it is
for real, we both just had babies and we are running on zero sleep. And so this is like a fever dream. Like me trying to guess your name, I won't remember this conversation in 1 second from like, no, we were both just like crazy insane from trying to put babies to sleep. Do you have any babies? Don't have babies.
Rob,
that's my advice.
I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you my morning routine.
Yeah.
Wake up 4:45 a.m.
Yeah.
Put on the Robert De Niro Al Pacino movie Heat. Watch the scene where they blow up that bank.
No, not appropriate for babies.
Full volume. Eat 2 Kit Kats, not the whole 4. I save the other 2 for later. All right. And make a protein drink.
Start your buzz saw. Your jackhammer.
I cut into a piece of my apartment, like just a piece. And every day I like use that to mark off how many days I'm alive. And then I scream out the window, I'm alive.
And then your baby wakes up.
Then I fight a dog. I fight a rabid dog. Not to the death, just a sparring partner.
Yeah.
You know, he's protected, I'm protected, and then the day begins.
Then the baby wakes up after all that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, yeah, good question. We still didn't get his secret.
Since we're on the theme of coke.
Don't make us get us.
Yeah, yeah.
One time I was on the bus, and there was a guy doing cocaine in front of me.
That's not a secret about you, Avon.
Yeah.
That's a secret about the other guy.
He's talking about other crimes.
I'll take it, Avon.
I couldn't think of anything, honestly.
That was good, by the way.
That's good. We'll take it.
Who else?
All right, we have time for one. Just one more. One more.
One more.
Yeah, that's it.
What's your name? What's your secret?
Sam, and I have a tattoo of a unicorn on my ass.
Whoa.
That's not true.
It is.
Show us.
Don't show us. Do not show that.
If you got a tattoo of a unicorn on your ass, it is meant to be shown. You can't be coy about that. It's not like, I don't want to show you. Yeah, you do, because you got it on your ass. I'm just saying, where on the ass?
Where on the ass?
Like,
is it
right middle of the cheek?
Oh, it's in the
I thought you were going to say middle of my butthole. Like right in the middle. It looks like I'm pooping out a unicorn.
Help! It's like coming out of the side. All right, your question. It's a lot of pressure. It's the last question.
I was just wondering what your favorite sketch was to make from Human Giant.
Ooh, that's
from Human Giant. That's a great question. Although a lot of people here don't know what Human Giant is.
Human Giant was a show that Rob and I did with Aziz for 2 years, and we took over MTV for 24 hours, which was one of the most fun things ever. They let us take over the TRL studios.
For some reason, they gave us this live for 24 hours straight.
And we like played music.
We had the band Mastodon on, like this crazy metal
people
band.
People were flying in. Like I remember like some of our friends, like Bob Odenkirk was Will flying Arnett. In New York. I was like, I got to come.
Yeah.
People came down.
Krasinski.
It was a moment.
Fun.
Yeah, Michael Cera.
That's probably the most fun thing is when we did this. We did that live show in Times Square.
The second season is completely unavailable anywhere, and I think the first season is also completely unavailable. You can get the DVD somewhere, but it's a shame, and I'm appealing to anyone out there who has any power. Put that out there in some way. We worked hard.
Do you think Donald Trump will put out our old sketch show?
I think it's a part of one of the executive orders.
Oh, great.
But it also like greenlights a bunch of awful things. It means that all the oceans will be just full of piss.
So his executive order is dogs get guns, fill the oceans with piss. But then the last thing is release Human Giant on DVD.
Yeah. And I'm going to say, I know you're going to have a few problems with some of those things, but we really want that Human Giant. And we want it to come out on just on DVD, not streaming.
Fill the oceans with piss.
Release the piss. So we did a bunch of sketches. Man, that's a good question. I would say one of my favorite ones was this one. Who asked that question? Where are you? Over there. Called Sci-Fi Makeup, which was I was a character on a show like
Star Trek. Yeah.
Like a Klingon character with a lot of makeup. And I would go into the makeup chair every day.
The makeup took forever to put on. So the actor decided.
I was like, I'll get plastic surgery and get this makeup permanently put on my face. Just to save time because I want to hang out with the cast.
And then as soon as he does that, of course, the show gets canceled.
And then it became like this story.
The life of this guy auditioning for other shows.
But looking like a Klingon. And then the end result of it was he finally got a job where they gooped up his makeup face with like white face. So it would cover the Klingon face, and it was just goop.
They put shitty human makeup over your Klingon face. Anyway, it's great, guys. You got to explaining comedy is fun. It's really fun.
Walking you through a sketch. That's But we did a lot of like story sketches like that though too. We weren't like a lot. We weren't like, hey, Rob, the pasta man.
The craziest thing. The craziest thing that they let us do. I think the craziest thing was, we did a sketch called Little 9/11. Which was, we had Tiny George Bush, Tiny Osama, played by little kids. Yeah. It was basically the drama behind 9/11.
Done with children.
But done with little kids. I mean, it was a terrible idea, and they let us do it. So it's
but
really
by the
on
way,
them.
We, yeah, like, you know, so having a little kid reading a storybook to other little kids and then getting whispered in his ear like that 9/11 happened and him looking like...
It was adorable. It was adorable 9/11.
The one sketch that we weren't ever able to air but we shot with Kristen Schaal was a religious abortion doctor.
Oh, God.
And it was, and I played a abortion doctor who was very religious. So I'd be like, God bless my hands as I take this baby out. And it was like, and then they were like, why are you even shooting this? We will never air it.
Even mentioning it here offends everyone.
It was
and me.
A very religious abortion doctor. He was like, I love the Lord, and I also love giving women abortions.
Zero people watching this like us now. We've alienated everyone. But anyway, look under your seats, guys. There's a big prize!
All right, we got to get out of here, but then some quick love, too, to your director on Human Giant,
Jason Wallner,
who's fantastic, behind the scenes. Yeah. But everyone check out DriveShare. You can get it for free. It's free.
Right, yeah, just go
no
to
money involved.
Go90.com.
Download the app. If you have Verizon, you don't even have to pay for the streaming.
That's right. Watch it on your phones or watch it on your computer and masturbate to it. No one cares.
Hey.
Yeah, just cover up the camera part. Yeah.
Is that true? When we masturbate, are we supposed to cover up the cameras now?
Oh, I think boy. That's a thing, but no wouldn't there be like
too much Black Mirror, man?
People jerking off in front of their computers out there by now. Like, who's sitting on it? Like, one day I'm gonna release every one of these.
Putin has footage of all of us masturbating. He's gonna blackmail all of us.
Plus, by the way, you very rarely would see a person's face in that. It would basically be like just getting you from like here down, right?
All right, Paul Scheer, Rob Huebel.
We're going to end it there.
Comedy superheroes.
He hit a kid with his car.
America Online.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Thank you.